Hi, Pastor Bill, Bethel Lutheran Church in Green Valley. Today is Tuesday. It's the 29th of September. Please pray with me. Lord Jesus, you are our rock. That is something that we can never question, something that never gets by us. You are our rock. It's upon you whom we depend. Grace our lives always with your forgiveness. Make us holy and ready to serve. Amen.
There is a truth older than the ages. There is a promise of things yet to come. There is one born for our salvation, Jesus. There is a light that overwhelms the darkness. There is a kingdom that forever reigns. There is freedom from the chains that bind us.
From yesterday, and it begins with the ninth verse. Paul writes, "So this is my prayer, that your love will flourish, and that you will not only love much, but well. Learn to love appropriately. You need to use your head and test your feelings so that your love is sincere and intelligent, not sentimental gush. Live a lover's life, circumspect and exemplary, a life Jesus will be proud of, bountiful in fruits from the soul, making Jesus Christ attractive to all, getting everyone involved in the glory and praise of God. I want to report to you, friends, that my imprisonment here has had the opposite of its intended effect. Instead of being squelched, the message has actually prospered. All the soldiers here, and everyone else too, found out that I'm in jail because of this Messiah. That piqued their curiosity, and now they've learned all about him. Not only that, but most of the followers of Jesus here have become far more sure of themselves in the faith than ever, speaking out fearlessly about God, about the Messiah." Here ends our scripture reading. This is Paul's prayer to his followers, to the other congregations, that their love would flourish, and that they would not only love a lot, but love well. The challenge to us as followers is to love well, to share Jesus' message of love frequently and well. Paul is concerned about his followers, and his concern spans eons of time. The concern that he writes of in his scripture here applies to us today. We are followers of the Christ. Paul is concerned about Christians of every day and time. And this scripture message is written for us in our present day. Too often I think we look at scripture and we think of it as a book that's, well, it's old, it's set in the past. We may even question its meaning in the here and now. But these are words that live in the here and now and are part of us, part of our lives. Paul writes a little bit of irony. Instead of being squelched, the message has actually prospered. He was put in prison. He was jailed because of his beliefs. You would think that that would go a long way towards shutting things down, shutting the message. But Paul writes, it had the opposite effect. Instead, people more than ever began to hear the message. This man who was in jail could not be silenced, to the point at which his jailers found out about Jesus. They learned about the Messiah. That's our job as followers, to share Jesus' love. May God bless you today and always. Amen. We close with the prayer our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. God go with you.